removing the barriers to deep space exploration, a commercial success for NASA's U.S. partners, and the latest mission to Mars seeks answers about its atmosphere. Those are some of the stories trending this week at NASA.
The Maven spacecraft is the latest NASA probe designed to help piece together a complete picture of the Red Planet's past. Maven's piece of the puzzle to understand what happened to Mars's upper atmosphere.
Why did it go from a wetter, Earth-like environment with a thicker atmosphere to where it is today, much more dry and thin atmosphere?
Following its launch from Cape Canaveral Air Force Station, Maven is scheduled to reach Mars in September 2014. Progress being made toward sending humans to deep space destinations was the topic of discussion during a roundtable at Washington's Museum featuring NASA's Bill Gerstenmaier.
We're putting in place hardware and capabilities that will allow us to go do the Mars-class mission.
And a new panoramic mosaic image released at the event and taken by NASA's Cassini spacecraft gives an idea of what humans might see if they were hanging out near Saturn. The nearly 405,000-mile sweeping view of the Saturnian system includes its moons and rings, as well as Earth, Venus, and Mars in the distance. The image is part of Cassini's recent Wave at Saturn campaign. During a news briefing at NASA headquarters to discuss the success of SpaceX and Orbital Sciences in the agency's Commercial Orbital Transportation Services, or COTS program, Administrator Charlie Bolden praised the companies for reestablishing reliable supply services to the ISS from U.S. soil. The October demonstration mission to the space station by Orbital Sciences marked the end of COTS development. The first SpaceX trip to the station was in May 2012. It completed its part in the COTS program that same year. NASA welcomed members of the traditional and social media to Goddard Space Flight Center to learn about the agency's next Earth science satellite, the Global Precipitation Measurement Mission. GPM will provide next-generation observations of rain and snow around the world every 3 hours. Targeted for launch early next year, GPM is a joint effort between NASA and the Japan Aerospace Exploration Agency. For the first time, NASA's Operation IceBridge is flying an Antarctica research campaign out of the National Science Foundation's McMurdo Station in Antarctica. IceBridge, which collects land and sea ice data, usually flies Antarctica missions out of Punta Arenas, Chile. Ames and Langley Research Centers are working with Boeing on a new technology application for the tail rudder section of a 757 aircraft. The technology features active airflow controls to enhance performance of the vertical tail, reduce drag, and save fuel. And that's what's up this week at NASA. For more on these and other stories, follow us on social media and visit www.nasa.gov/twan.